Hello everybody, welcome back. It's good to see you again. The other day I pulled out my sketchbook while I was watching some TV. Gravity Falls. I don't know if you've heard of it. It's a cartoon, Disney cartoon. It's on Hulu right now. Only two seasons, so it's not too hard to binge watch, but we're not through it yet. I find it quite funny and enjoyable, and I like the cartoon style, the animation style. So I thought to myself, why don't I try and mimic that style and draw myself as a Gravity Falls character? So, I'm going to show you here the process of bringing this creation, this sketch to life via Adobe Illustrator. It is a vector-based program for doing artwork and whatnot. It's a fun program that I like to use, and it's neat because you can create art in it without using a drawing tablet. You can use just a mouse. You just create shapes and move the points, and it can all be done with just the old good old-fashioned mouse. I, however, find it best if I start with a sketch. So I draw something on paper and then I take a picture of it and import that picture into Adobe Illustrator. And then I can create my shapes and color it and everything on top of that image. I'm just adjusting the opacity and whatnot so that I can see the image below it. And it's pretty fun. So I've had quite a fun time watching Gravity Falls recently and decided it would be fun to make myself a character. And in order to do this, it was kind of fun because I basically looked at a bunch of the characters that already exist in the show and found elements that me and both those characters have in common. For example, the glasses on my character here comes from the same glasses that Grunkle Stan has. Great Uncle Stan, that is the uncle character in this show, and he's one of the only few who did have glasses, so I borrowed that concept. My face, however, is shaped more like the character Robbie, who is a teenage boy and has a crush on another character named Wendy, who just happens to be the character I use to get my t-shirt. She wears like a flannel button-up shirt, and well, I do too often a lot, so I just figured a button-up shirt style, kind of like hers, would work for my character. My body type and my long legs also came from the Robbie character. But then I looked at the main character Dipper, one of the twins, one of the main characters, and tried to borrow facial features from him. Now I noticed that this reference image that you keep seeing here on the right is actually not the original characters. It is some fan-made image where all of the characters are gender switched. So I didn't notice that until like halfway through, but that is A-okay because it still, I mean, still provided the resource that I needed to be able to match the details and just, you know, it was a good inspiration board. So I'm still not an expert in Adobe Illustrator. I make mistakes and have to undo and redo things a lot. So you see that here, it's not the most eloquent process. It, you know, comes together in bits and pieces. Quite different than traditional medium, but I do like this program because it does allow you to take shortcuts in easily adjusting lines and, you know, copying and pasting and all that sort of stuff. It just takes some practice so that you can get into the workflow of it. I like that on the eyebrows, I made them too big at first, and I can easily round them out just by dragging a little slider and adjusting them. So anyway. The hairstyle, of course, is purely me. I didn't get that from any other character. I just tried to mimic my normal hairstyle. So, then after I got the basic shapes in there, I started adding details, adding shadows and highlights, and I still used the reference pictures to see how the original creators did highlights and shadows in their characters. And then I used masks in order to embed like the stripes, the shapes of my shirt within that frame, within that outline, and as well with some of the other elements like shadows and stuff. And just kind of got it all organized and put together, and it came along quite nicely. Now, for those of you who might be thinking, Ford, how can I do this? This looks super fun. And by the way, it is really fun. But unfortunately, Adobe Illustrator costs like an arm and a leg, and maybe you can't, I don't know, dish out that kind of dough. Well, first of all, you could consider going to college, like I do, and hopefully that your institution will provide you with a free resource to Adobe Illustrator and Photoshop and yada yada yada. But if that is not the case, Adobe Illustrator is not necessary. Inkscape is a free vector-based drawing software that I have used. It is very similar to Adobe Illustrator. There are minor differences, but you know, I was able to Google it and figure out how to learn it before I got Illustrator. And you can, with that program, create pictures and images just like this without having a drawing tablet, which also, you know, can cost money. I think the one I got now was 50 or 100 bucks. So if you want to invest in some art, get a drawing tablet because they are super fun and make drawing in Photoshop quite exciting. But like I said, you don't have to have that. You can use Inkscape. You can use those kind of programs to draw without having to actually draw. You just make shapes. So anyway, I think I'm about finished with this. So let's see how it turned out. Well, there's the end result. And you know what? I like it. I hope you do too. And remember to smile. If you enjoyed this video, check out my other videos. I have more art videos. I have some candy review videos and all sorts of other fun stuff here on this channel. So subscribe if you want to see more and hit that little bell icon. Have a good day. And I'll see you next time.